go ahead and take a comfortable seat on your mat. If you feel more comfortable having your legs extended like this, you're more than welcome to do that. Rest your hands onto your thighs for a second. Just take a moment to check in. Relax your shoulders down from your ear. And then place one hand onto your belly and one onto your heart. We're just gonna check in with our breath here. So take a nice deep inhale. And exhale. Now start to notice where your breath is. Do you feel more expansion into your belly or more into your upper chest? Just take a couple rounds of breath. Tune into your body. And I want you to start to breathe more into the belly hand. So deep inhale, let the hand on the belly move out. Then into the chest. Then exhale the chest first. And then the belly back towards the spine. Do that again. Inhale, belly first, then into upper chest. Exhale, upper chest, and then belly. Now drop the hands, but keep the technique. If you'd like to keep your eyes open, you're free to do that. Or you can close them just to feel the breath a little bit more consciously. And then go ahead and count how long your inhale is naturally. And then exhale, counting how long your exhale is. And let's try to match the inhale with the exhale. Good. Now see if you can create a four count. So you're inhaling for four and exhaling for four. Creating an even breath, inhale to exhale. From here, we're gonna go into box breathing. So we're gonna still inhale for four. We're going to hold for four, exhale for four, and hold for four. Inhale, four, hold for four, exhale, four, hold for four. Do one more on your own. Really feel the breath that moves into your body, giving you energy and oxygen and relaxation as you exhale. Good. Then drop the technique and return to normal breathing, and let's flutter the eyes open. You're gonna bring your hands onto your knees and round the spine. All the way back, and inhale, arching up, looking up all the way towards the ceiling. Exhale, rounding the spine. Inhale, looking all the way up, opening up the chest, spreading the collarbones. One more, cat. And inhale into the cow position. Good. Return to a neutral spine. We're gonna go into a spinal twist. We're going to bring our right hand back and look over our right shoulder. Inhale back to center. And exhale, turn to the left. Inhale back to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale back to center. Exhale left. And one more each side at your own pace. Keep making the spine as long as possible. Breath stays nice and steady. Good, and I'll meet you back in the center. Let's place our right hand down on the floor beside you. And reach the left arm all the way up and over. Good, and you're gonna feel a nice stretch in the left side body. Good. Inhale back up, land on the other side. Reaching up with the right arm. Good, inhale back up. If you'd like to go a little bit further, Slide the hand out and drop the elbow down as you reach over. Inhale back up. Repeat on the other side. And we're gonna go back over to the right and we're gonna hold this for a second. So choose if you wanna be on the hand or the elbow. And just find the spot where you feel the most stretch in that left side body. For some people, it might be opening up the heart to the ceiling a little bit more, or rounding down towards the floor just a little bit. And breathe deeply into that spot. Good. Inhale back up. Let's repeat that on the left. So sliding the hand down, reaching over with the right arm, getting a nice stretch all the way through the lats, side body, opening up the ribs. And inhale, back up to front. Good. We're gonna try and open up the ribs a little bit more. So lift up the right arm and just to visualize that you're breathing all the way into that right lung. Good. Exhale, back down. Inhale, up again. Exhale, back down. Let's do that on the left. Inhale, left arm all the way up. Exhale, back down. One more, inhale. All the way up. And exhale back down. Okay, both arms together, reaching the arms all the way up as wide as you can, spreading those collarbones. Nice deep breath. Exhale back down. Inhale one more, all the way up. Good. And exhale back down. Good. Roll the shoulders out. Exhale. Creaks and pops, and that's absolutely normal. Let's change direction forward. You're doing such a good job, you guys. Good, and relax the head on down. We're gonna drop the right ear down towards the right shoulder. And this is gonna stretch out the left upper trap. Breathe deep into that stretch. Let that feel really good. Now you can stay here, or if you'd like to add on a little bit more, you're gonna bring the left hand behind the back, just ever so slightly to add on a little bit more. Inhale back to center, dropping the left ear down towards the left shoulder. And if you need to add on the arm, go ahead and do that. But it's also perfectly fine to just rest that hand onto the knee. Stretch, feel really good. Deep breath in. And release back up. Wonderful. We're gonna come onto hands and knees. So lean on forward, shift your legs back. If you need to move your props aside, go ahead and do so. So we'll have the hands directly underneath the shoulders or knees right underneath the hips. Good. So we're gonna go into the same movements, but we're in a different position. So we're engaging our core a little bit more. So we're gonna tuck the tailbone around the spine, bring the chin to the chest, inhale, looking up. Good. Exhale all the way down. Inhale up. One more, exhale, curling in that tailbone, tuck, tuck, tuck. And inhale back to neutral. Good. From here, I'd like you to sit back all the way and stretch out your arms in front of you. Good, and bring the right hand on top of the left hand. So it's gonna be on the left side of your mat. And what this is gonna do is create a little bit of a side stretch in the right body. Good, very good. Inhale deeply into that right lung. And release, come back to center. And then move your left hand on top of your right, the right side of your mat. And sit back into that child's pose again, opening up the left side. Very good.
Inhale back to center, and then sit back up onto hands and knees. From here, we're gonna reach the right arm all the way up to the sky. So we're rotating our body open. Good. From here, we're sliding the right hand in between the hand and the knee, and we're landing down onto the shoulder. And you can rest the head down. Now you can stay here with your left hand, or you can reach your left hand overhead. Breathe. Bring your left hand back to support yourself as you slowly come up. And we're gonna reach back up to the sky with that right arm again. And then we lower the hand down. Very good. From here, we're gonna do that on the left side. So reach the left arm all the way up. Nice big rotation in the chest. And slide it all the way through between the hand and the knee. And then choose what variation you'd like. If you need to reach the arm up overhead, you're welcome to do that. Slide the hand back. Press into the right hand as you lengthen the right arm all the way up to the sky, and come down into hands and knees. Sit all the way back, bring your knees slightly apart for a child's pose. Now there's some variations. You can have your arms straight out in front of you, or if you'd like to have them alongside your body, you can tuck them alongside your legs. Take a moment to breathe here. You're gonna feel your lungs expand. You're gonna feel your ribs go out into your thighs. And just tune in to your breath. Notice how it's changed from the beginning of your class. Good. From here, we're gonna come straight up into hands and knees again. Now I want you to curl the toes underneath you. Good. We're going to go into our first downward dog. Now the focus is not to have your heels on the ground. Instead, please keep your knees slightly bent so we take the tension out of our hamstrings. So we're going to push into our hands and slowly lift our knees off the mat as our hips come up to the sky. As we do this, we're straightening out our spine as much as we can. Now the emphasis is not, I'm gonna check how this is going. Bend your knees just ever so slightly, good. And then lengthen out throughout your spine, bring your hips back. There we go. Good, wonderful. From here, you're gonna come back into your tabletop, so dropping your knees down onto the floor. And we're gonna move in and out of that position a couple times. So push into your hands, back into your downward dog. Deep breath in. And exhale, return down. Now your choice, you can come into that hands and knees or hover the knees just above the mat, then press back into downward dog. Good, one more. Hands and knees or hover, and then push back downward dog. Now your choice if you'd like to stay there or start to pedal out the feet. Feel free to do that. Good, then slowly come back into that main downward dog. Drop your knees down to the floor and rest back down into child's pose. We're gonna inhale, look up, and come forward onto our bellies. We're gonna keep the hands just underneath our shoulders. Our elbows are tucked alongside our body. And we're gonna keep our spine as strong and straight as we can as we first lower our head down. Then inhale, look up. You start to feel your back muscles activate. And then push lightly into your hands. Good. So we're working all of those back muscles for posture, spinal correction. Exhale back down. Two more.
Inhale, lift.
Good. Tapping in those elbows, strong through your legs. Exhale back down.
One more. Inhale, lift. And exhale back down.
Go ahead and push on up onto hands and knees. We're going to come into a sitting position. You can cross your legs if you'd like. We're going to go into a little bit of a self massage. So I want you to bring your hands together and warm up the palms. Keep them nice and warm. And from here, we're going to place the palms right onto our eyes and let the hands just gently warm up the forehead. And release, bringing the hands down towards the neck. So we're going to massage the neck muscles a little bit. If you would like to go to the opposite side, you can do one side at a time. Now there are different techniques here. We can make a little C shape with our hand and to squeeze that muscle. Or we can bring the fingers close together and make little circles. Now see if you can find a couple of those tight spots that have been bothering you today and loosen them up a little bit. Good. Keep working on one side. Remember to switch sides. And find out which technique works better for you. Good. Then bring the fingertips right to the base of your head, just where your neck begins. There's some little muscles here that if we circle around, you might feel some tight spots there. They cause a lot of headaches, so it's good to release those. And then we're gonna sweep the fingers down the neck and to release some of the neck muscles. Good. Now you can continue to do that, or if you'd rather make a C shape and squeeze the neck to create more release for those muscles. Go ahead and do that. Good. Let's bring the fingertips to the sides of the cheeks, and it's right but in front of your ear. We're going to move in some circles. Some jaw muscles here that can get really tight, and we want to make sure that they get to relax a little bit. Throughout the day, we might clench our teeth a little bit too much, or that can start to trigger some headaches. Good. Bring your hands up towards the temple. Good. And then the eyebrows. Circles as well. Maybe right between the brow with one hand if that feels comfortable for you. And then back with two hands to the forehead. Good. And then if you want, you can kind of get into your hair and massage the scalp. There's some muscles there that can also contribute to headaches. It can feel good just to release those a little bit more. And release the hands down if you want. Sometimes it feels good to kind of give those arms a little bit of love after all the hard work that they did. Good. Let's go ahead and lay down onto our backs. And I want you to bring one knee into the chest and drop it over towards the opposite side. So let's bring the right knee up and then drop it over to the left. Your right arm will go out to the side as you twist the spine. Inhale, back up to center. Bring the left knee in towards your chest and drop it over to the right. Inhale back to center. Now you can let the legs hang out long, so you can stretch out your legs out in front of you, arms out to the side. you can close your eyes and take a moment to be with your breath. Check in and see how your breath might have changed from the beginning of the class. Feel free to stay here for as long as you'd like, or you can progress to the next video.